This is my sad Keanu face because top five is just not enough. I'm going to give you two lists. It was the top five I thought was going to be my top five, and then what my top five actually was for this year. So, Children of Bodom, Hexed. I thought that it's one of the best Bodom albums they've done since before Are You Dead Yet? It's just awesome. All the catchy Bodom stuff, all the songwriting structures that they kind of grew into over time, awesome lyrics, which I just don't think have been a thing for me with Bodom for a little while. Just everything came together on this album, and I've been listening to it heaps. And yet, somehow it didn't make my top five, so that's sad Keanu won. Killswitch Engage, Atonement. Riff City. I don't know what to say about Killswitch Engage. Everything they've done since Jesse's come back, and I was not a huge Jesse fan at the start, has been amazing. Disarm to Descent was incredible, and then it's just been amazing since then. So... Atonement just follows along. It's fantastic. I don't really have much else to say with that one. Also didn't make my top five. In Flames, Eye the Mask. I had a weird relationship with that one because, again, all the In Flames riffs and all the catchy choruses that the new stuff sort of caught onto. And I loved it. I loved it a lot. And then other things came along. Sad Keanu 3. As I Lay Dying, Shaped by Fire. To be fair, this one was just... riff factory and just melody factory. So like my favorite parts of this album was just hitting play and just expecting to hear riffs nonstop. And I've been in that mood this year. And again, it's another reason I thought it would make my top five, because it was literally just like, you know, I may have got a few speeding fines listening to this album. And Sad Keanu 4 did not make my top five when I thought it would. Flesh God Apocalypse, Valeno. After having the member change up and everything, I was like super keen to hear what they were gonna do. And it's probably their best album, in my opinion. It's pretty much flawless for them. And watching them play a lot of it live was incredible. And it just gives me so many feels. I love that album. And that's Sad Keanu 5, because that didn't make my top five.
So my number five album would be Sleep Token's Sundowning. Very weird, synthy... proggy poppy album with random metal bits put in. It would be like if Triple J tried to actually make a metal album and then got sidetracked with all of the synthy poppy wave stuff. Awesome, awesome album. And also they're pretty secret, so, you know, adds to the mystery.
All right, so my top albums of 2019 are Mordial by Carbon. Insanely heavy, some cool weird effects, catchy melodic, and at the same time, they've got this kind of cool retro vibe going on. There's almost some grunge shit, so it makes my list. These are in no particular order, by the way.
All right, so I first want to preface this by saying that last year, I didn't even listen to five metal albums. This made Kez very upset.
I gave the Black Album by Metallica a fair few spins.
I hate you.
So I made it an effort this year to listen to at least five, to make a top five list. Which I did. Squeezing in at number five is a band, Shadow of Intent, who I didn't even know existed till recently. The album is called Melancholy. It's just like a super heavy, almost Black Dahlia murder style album. I think Trevor's actually on one of the songs as well. And favorite track would be, I think it's called Thonic something. I don't know. It's hard to pronounce. That album just slaps, very heavy. I'm glad people introduced me to them. Didn't know they existed till then.
Top five albums of 2019 for Dwagon Calves. Well, I'm cheating because there were too many good albums this year, so I'm going to do top five pairings using this plate and this wine glass as props. Okay, in no particular order, the first one, Cattle Decapitation, Death Atlas. Wow, what an album. It's just massive. The drums are nuts. The vocals are crazy. The guitar work is amazing. Just everything about it is great. I've been a fan of Cattle Decapitation for a little while, but it's always been I like Cattle Decapitation. But I can officially say they're fucking amazing. I love them. It's not even a like thing anymore. The second album, which pairs beautifully with Cattle Decapitation, is Gatecreepers Deserted. If you like traditional death metal, this is definitely an album that you need to get. There's HM2 all over it. It's just big and angry, and it's probably one of the best death metal albums of the last 10 years, hands down. no questions asked. If you're angry about that statement, you need to relax and live your life.
My actual top five. Insomnium, Heart Like a Grave. I don't know how to feel with this album. It makes me happy, it makes me sad, it makes me all the things, and that's what Insomnium does best. I love this album so much. It takes all the best parts of Winter's Gate and then mixes it with all the stuff that I got into Insomnium for from earlier on, like the, I guess the more riffier melodic tendencies that weren't quite as like slow and brooding, and yet they managed to pull you in with some of that stuff and then throw the slow and brooding, and then just when you think you're all excited, boom, they just pull your heart right out. And yeah, amazing album. So
wow, 2019 was an amazing year for music. Honestly, there was so many good bands that put out new albums, like so much good music. Like there were so many albums I couldn't even put in my top five. When I actually sat down and started trying to write a top five, I started just listing, oh, everyone's going to think of that one. Of course they're going to say Kez put that one. So, and then I realized I was just writing top five pretentious albums that I like to say I listen to be a music wanker. So here's that list now. But I thought, let's actually just write the top five albums that just haven't left my CD player this year. Starting with number one. I've got a gimmick, you see, it's cool. Children of Bodom's Hexed. It's Bodom. It's classic Bodom. This album sits in some beautiful somewhere point between Follow the Reaper and Hatecrew Deathroll, yet has a lot of the riffage of Blood Drunk on it, I found. I absolutely love this album. Bodom is one of my all-time favorite metal bands. Like, I really couldn't. This album was great, and it's sad that the band has since had Events!
My fourth album would be Insomnium's Heart Like a Grave. Have you heard it? Oh my god. Oh my god. Oh my god. It's so good. So many feels. I've been listening to the bonus version where the final three tracks are all instrumental and they're all awesome. Also, like, they can, you know, be real heart-wrenching even with none of the singing, so. Nice. Yes.
Periphery 4, Hail Stan. Some of you may know, some of you probably don't know, I play in another band called Hollow World. We were on tour in Europe when they dropped the first single for this album called Blood Eagle. I woke up really early one morning, everyone was asleep on the tour bus, went out to the lounge area, put my headphones in, and got absolutely annihilated by how stupidly heavy that song is. If you're going to listen to anything, listen to Blood Eagle, and it will make you feel some heavy feels.
Soilwork, Vergleiden. Dirk Vibeuren is probably my favorite drummer on the planet, and Soilwork are one of my favorite bands. So when he left, I shit a few bricks, just being like, "Oh no, how do you replace him?" And the answer is the new drummer. So thank you, Mr. Thusberg, for being incredible and being a part of probably Soilwork's just most ambitious album. I love it. It's not what I expected. I expected more of a continuation from Ride Majestic, which is kind of where they were going after Living Infinite. And then they basically just incorporated a whole bunch of the Night Flight Orchestra stuff, took all the sick 80s synths, and then made a Soilwork album out of it. How can you not love that? So that's number two in my top five. Again, no particular order.
And this was close. But I'm going to give it to Bodom, Hexed. It's just like a nostalgia gasm. They've got a lot of riffs that sound just like Hatebreeder and Follow the Reaper. That album pretty much just like scratches an itch that really needs to be scratched. Favorite track off that would probably be This Road, I believe it's called, one of the singles. Huge track, yeah, very throwbacky, typical Alexi riffs. Solos all over the shop. Sick album.
So secondly, I'll go with Refused's War Music. What a great album. Angry year for an angry band. I mean, Refused have been doing this for a long time, and as far as hardcore punk is concerned, they are the kings. This album's really catchy as well. It's got some really poignant parts to it, and they've always got those nice tie-ins with the political issues they've got with the world. To match with them, I've got Order in Decline by Sum 41. I haven't really paid attention to Sum 41 for a little while, and when I grabbed this album, I was blown away. It's just got some great riffs, great hooks, and just is a great sounding album all around.
Album number two. What was that wink? Dragon Forces, extreme power metal. Extreme power metal. The top five of the album. I can't remember what it's called. Dragon Force is extreme power metal. I've been a big Dragon Force fan for a long time, and although they've put out somewhat similar albums over the years, this album was a beautiful blend of everything classic I loved about the band, slash with just enough fun experimental moments and some great cheesy 80s and video game retro sounds and ballads that I had such a fun time with this album that I really just in good conscience couldn't put it in my top five. I'm throwing it onto a soft pillow. This is a safe move.
My third choice would be Soen. This is a band I found on a random like Spotify playlist earlier this year, and their album Lotus has just absolutely blown me away. Apparently they're some kind of super group, but here's the thing, I've never heard of any of the like bands that any of the members are originally part of, so... Is it even a super group?
Andy Gillian's solo album, Never After. It's just huge. Andy's like a beautifully handsome man as well, but he's a virtuoso. He's insane. I feel like he'll just be that type of guy that writes music till he drops dead. He's like a riff machine. The album's amazing. And my favorite song is Skyless, the one with Jeff Loomis. Huge track.
Third, I've got Swallow the Suns, When the Shadow is Forced into the Light. What a great album. It's super bleak, super dark, but still super catchy. I don't know how they do it, but they've been doing it for a long time, and it just blows my mind. They've been a favorite band of mine for a long time now, and just every time they release something, I'm blown away. And I'm matching that with Insomnium's Heart Like a Grave. Again, bleak, dark, but catchy. How do they do it? I'm blown away by these guys. It just kills me. Like, having the pleasure of touring with them, they're top dudes, so I don't know how they can be this sad. Really, what's wrong? Talk to me. I'm here. Talk to me.
Gillian, Never After. I hate that I know someone who's as talented as this because it makes me hate everything I do. The album's incredible. It is just... It's like if Fantasia was an album, that's it. It's like if Disney wrote a metal album... This would be it. I hate you, Andy. You magnificent bastard. So check it out. It's incredible.
Number three. Throw everything. That's what I'm doing. Except the tea. I'll drink that. In Flames, I the Mask. Now, In Flames are my favorite metal band. I will not apologize to anyone about saying that. And except for one, I have liked every album they've ever made. And this new album... is no different. I loved Battles, and this album sounds like a beautiful, interesting mix of A Sense of Purpose, Come Clarity, and Battles. It's got some of their heaviest and most interesting riffage in years, with some of their catchiest choruses. I love the vocals approach to this. I love the slight experimental nature. It's probably a lot more stripped back pop metalcore than any of their other albums, but I'm very happy with that. Love you.
Never After by Andy Gillian. I'm biased, he's a good friend of mine, but Jesus, that is an incredible album. The mix and master is ridiculous, but what's even more ridiculous is the guitar playing. Listen to it or else Andy will kill you.
Number two is Heart Like a Grave by Insomnium. One word, valediction. Need I say more?
My second album would be Periphery, and their album Periphery 4, Hail Stan. Fantastic album. They just can't do anything wrong. I think there was like one song on the album that I wasn't the biggest fan of, but it was still an interesting song. My favorite song on that album is probably the best song title I have ever heard in a song ever, which would be It's Only Smiles. If you understand the joke of that, you're a pervert and you should be locked up.
Dream Theater, Distance Over Time. I don't think you could have paid me enough to say that I was going to have a Dream Theater album in my top five, probably in the last 10 plus years, because I don't think I've really loved a Dream Theater album since Train of Thought. That album to me is just perfect in every way, and I just feel like everything after that got wankier and wankier, and don't get me wrong, I'm down for some like instrument wank, but the songs just never grabbed me. after that point. And after Mangini joined, it's like, oh, you know, it's lacking the Portnoy rock starness and all of that. And it did for a little bit, but I feel like this album, they actually have like completely found their feet. It's got, I just feel like it's such a more sensible album. There's all the wanky parts, but they're just like interwoven. It doesn't feel like, all right, we're going to stop this section just to put in all the sick guitar playing, keyboard playing, etc. It just feels like such a complete album. And I think it's some of James LaBrie's best work by far in the band. It's, yeah, it floored me. It actually floored me. And so I've been just binging that really hard this year.
And fourth, I've got two things that I haven't heard before this year, obviously. And they're two groups that have really blown me away. The first is The Moth Gatherer with Esoteric Oppression. Holy hell, the ambience, the mood, and the 80s horror sci-fis. I don't know how much they're watching John Carpenter. They're watching John Carpenter. The music is incredible. It's just everything I like about cinema, but in an album. And it's still metal as fuck. And I'm matching that with Street Cleaners Annihilation. Again, it's John Carpenter and the 80s, and I love it. It is an album that I could have as a soundtrack to me doing stuff. It's just so great. I wish I had a narrative that was as good as that album in my life. And I wish I did. Directed by John Carpenter.
Death Atlas by Cattle Decapitation. I shouldn't even need to comment on this.
Number four. I already threw the remote, so I guess I'm just going to do this and the edit will make it look good. Motionless in White's Disguise. Now, potentially being the winner of the worst album cover of the year, look at it. It's terrible. Fun fan theory. The back has this really cool dark raven, which I 100% reckon that was originally their album artwork. And halfway through, one of the band members or someone went, "Hey guys, In Flames, Sounds of the Playground Fading, we just drew that album cover." And they're like, "Oh shit, what existing album artwork do we have? Oh, we have this SketchUp. Let's just put it out with that." This album is literally just having Danny Elfman write Edward Scissorhands' soundtrack while punching you in the face with metalcore bangers. I want that. It's great.
And number one really surprised me myself. I have to give it to Alevady. I may be pronouncing this wrong. I think it's Ategnatos. Some Greek word, probably. I don't know what it means. Doesn't matter. That album goes really hard. Favorite song is, I think it's called Threefold Death. It just sounds like old school Dark Tranquility, the whole album. It's very traditional mellow death. This might be controversial, but I think like I'd probably enjoy the band more if they had less woodwindy type instruments. That's just my personal taste. But they use it in a very creative way. The song structures on that album are like very non-typical. It was just very unexpected for me to put that in there because I've always liked Alevady, but I think this is like the heaviest album they've written by far. And I've super surprised myself that I've put that as number one, but there's just some tracks on there that are crazy good. And that's it.
I feel like even if you didn't like this album, you're wrong and it should be in your top five. Cattle Decapitation's Death Atlas. I don't have words. I have feels and they are just anger and happiness all at once. It is the most brutal thing I've heard in such a long time. And for a band that's been around as long as they have, this is easily their best album. Like, I don't have a real description for this album. It is just huge. It is relentless. It is entirely ambitious. It's like everyone's turned themselves to like 150% of their abilities. And the mix is incredible too. Ugh, it's an incredible album. If you disagree, you're objectively wrong. That's it. And that's my top five of 2019.
And last but certainly not least, Killswitch Engage Atonement. What an album. Killswitch Engage can just keep doing what they do, as far as I'm concerned. It's catchy, it's riffy, it's just big. And Atonement is a really, really great album. I probably came to it late compared to everyone else, but holy hell, it's just great. And just the energy and the emotion that you can feel in that album is nuts. And I'm pairing that with Norma Jean's All Hail. Huge! Stop riffing like that. you're hurting my brain and you're hurting the ecosystem. It breaks things and I can't wait to hear it live when you're down in Australia, because those riffs are so fucking big that I think we may tear down some walls. And that's my top five for 2019.
This is a Blu-ray player. What am I doing with myself?
The new Insomnium. It's so good. It's just classic mellow death, dark, emotional, gothic, powerful, ambient yet crushing. Like, how do you make something so ambient yet so emotional, so powerful, with such riffage and great solos? I'm loving everything Yane has brought to the band in this album. It's great. I can't wait to see them again. Yay, Insomnium 2019.
My number one album for 2019 would be Orpheus Omega's Wear Your Sins. Now, I know, controversial. How can an Orpheus Omega member say their album is the best? Point one, I wasn't part of the album when it was made. Point two, I wasn't in the band when the album was released. Point three, it's a great fucking album. Everyone should be able to enjoy it, including you. Including me. I loved it. It was great. You've heard it. You like this band. You obviously have heard it.
You sycophant!
It's okay, we're done.
Is that?
We're done.
Oh, was that it?
We're done. Oh.